Hi, my name is Peter Walker. I want to reflect briefly on this concept of worthiness. In Revelation chapter 5 in the Bible, John is in the midst of a deep vision and involvement in heaven. And in this chapter, chapter 5, there's a question over who is worthy to open a scroll. And there's this moment of tenseness where in heaven there's a scroll that needs to be opened, and the question is who is worthy, and no one is found worthy. And John, the visionary, feels this so deeply, he begins to weep. He weeps because no one is worthy to open the scroll. In life, there is a quandary at the core of our being regarding the issue of being worthy. We often see it, or we can get a taste of how deep this runs when we listen to ourselves try to take hold of and enjoy life. Often we're seeking some kind of justification. For example, even in terms of just one's job or what one owns, often knowing that there's a disparity between people with and people without in life, often we're racing in our minds to justify what it is we have, or to seek a footing of worthiness, even to enjoy possession. Like we'll say, well, I worked hard for this, or I deserve this, you deserve this, and we often say, you deserve that, and hopefully there's some reciprocating authority given to us saying, well, you deserve that. And everybody's seeking a sense of justification or a sense of worthy, being worthy, even to just taste and experience things we have with peace in our mind. So there is a question that runs very deep regarding worthiness in the very soul of our being, just in terms of creation, just in terms of possession. It speaks of in Ecclesiastes, however, that to enjoy the fruit of our labor, even that, even to enjoy it, is not a given. It's a gift from God. So there is something in the very core of the soul of man that questions this issue of worthiness. Now, in Revelation 5, when they find the Lamb who was slain, who is Jesus, and he is worthy to open the scroll, he is worthy. There's this jubilant explosion in the heavenlies of thousands and thousands. It says 10,000 times 10,000 angels appear, and they're singing, "Worthy is the Lamb," for power and strength, but also for wealth. There's this sense that he who centers and anchors and gives authority to creation itself was present, the Lamb, Jesus Christ. It is he who is worthy. It is he who gives existence a justification, not just a reality, but a justification that it is, and it's on his authority. He is worthy to say life is. Now, this it gets very deep in terms of our soul, in terms of things we've done and things done to us. It's very, very good news that there is a King of Kings, that there is a Lamb who was slain, Jesus Christ, who is worthy to define. Because things you may have done, you wish you had not have done, sins we have committed, selfishness that we have enacted on other people, even what we do and what we say does not have the authority to ultimately define. And this is great news. Things done to you by the selfishness of other people, maybe humiliating experiences, exposing shameful experiences, they do not, despite even your deepest feelings of hurt and agony, those things do not have the ultimate say on who you are. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. It is Him who has the ultimate say on our very soul, not just existence. Isaiah 1:18, the prophet says, "Come, let us reason together. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be white as snow." Hebrews 12:24, speaking of this Lamb who was slain, says, "There is a blood, his blood, that speaks a better word than the blood of Cain, the blood of suffering, the blood of murder. So this is good news, the news of the gospel, that through the blood of the Lamb, because he was slain, again in Revelation 5, verse 9, it says he purchased men with that blood. He purchased me, he's purchased you, and he wants to have the ultimate say. He is worthy to define creation, and he's worthy to define your soul and call it forgiven and call it free and call it true. I'll end with this verse. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old has gone and the new has come. That's great news.